So we are going to derive some basic properties of even and odd numbers using the power of modular arithmetic. If you aren't familiar with the basics of modular arithmetic, I have a video on that, so you can check the link in the description and then come back here. First of all, let's talk about the definition of even and odd numbers in terms of modular arithmetic. We'll use the letter E to denote an even number. So this is not 2.718, this is just an integer. This integer is even if it is congruent to 0 mod 2. And that's because if it's congruent to 0 mod 2, that means that the difference, e minus 0, is a multiple of 2. Or in other words, e is a multiple of 2, so it's even. On the other hand, for an odd number, which we'll denote by the letter d so that it doesn't look like a 0, a number is odd if it's congruent to 1 mod 2. So with this second statement, by the definition of modular congruence, it's saying d minus 1 is some multiple of 2. And if we add 1 on both sides, we see this means that our odd number d is equal to 2k plus 1, which is what we generally expect an odd number to look like. So from here, we can start deriving some properties of even and odd numbers, because we know that any even number is congruent to 0 mod 2, and any odd number is congruent to 1 mod 2. First, let's take a look at some properties of sums. We know that we can add the two numbers on the left and right sides of modular congruences. So let's think about if we have two even numbers, E1 and E2, what is their sum? Well, we know E1 plus E2, both of those are congruent to 0. So their sum is congruent to 0 plus 0 mod 2. And we know that 0 plus 0 is, of course, 0. So E1 plus E2 is congruent to 0 mod 2. Now we know that if any number is congruent to 0 mod 2, then it is even. And therefore we've shown that the sum of two even numbers is always an even number. Next, let's look at an even plus an odd number. So say we have even plus an odd number. We know that an even number is congruent to 0, and an odd number is congruent to 1 mod 2. So from here, on the right side, we have 0 plus 1. So an even number plus an odd number is congruent to 1 mod 2. We know if a number is congruent to 1, then it is an odd number. And therefore, an even number plus an odd number will always be odd. Now we'll look at the last case, which is two different odd numbers. So say we have D1 plus D2. In that case, we know that both of these are going to be congruent to 1 mod 2. So we have 1 plus 1 on the other side of our congruence. Of course, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. But because we're working with mod 2, we know that 2 is congruent to 0 mod 2. So this sum of two odd numbers is congruent to 0 mod 2, because we know 2 is congruent to 0. And if this sum is congruent to 0, by definition it must be an even number. And therefore the sum of two odd numbers is always even. So now we're going to take a look at the rules for multiplying. What happens when we multiply two numbers that are either even or odd? We'll go through all the cases that we just saw. We know that an even number is congruent to 0, and an odd number is congruent to 1. So if we have two even numbers, E1 and E2, and we multiply them, the result is going to be congruent to 0 times 0, since each of these numbers is congruent to 0. Of course, 0 times 0 is going to give us the result of 0, which means that when we multiply two even numbers, the result is always even. For even times an odd number, we're looking at 0 times 1. But it doesn't matter whether it's a 1 over here, because we have an even number, we're going to multiply by 0. And anytime we multiply by 0, we're going to get 0 as our result. So when we multiply an even and an odd number, it's congruent to 0, which means it is also even. For the last case down here, we're multiplying two odd numbers, which means both of these are congruent to 1. So on the right side, we have 1 times 1 mod 2. This time we don't have any zeros, and 1 times 1 is equal to 1. Which means that when we multiply two odd numbers, the result is 1 mod 2, which means it is also odd. So that's how we can easily derive the properties of even and odd numbers using modular arithmetic. We know that an even number is congruent to 0, and an odd number is congruent to 1, and from that we can easily do some addition on zeros and ones to get all of the identities that we need.